Hi and welcome to the channel. In today's video, we will have two parts. So first is the teardown of this MLLSE RX6600M. The goal of this teardown is to hopefully see if there are traces of refurbishing. So let's start. So looking at the graphics card, there are 4 screws here and 2 screws here. So as usual, if you are removing screws from a graphics card, remember where it was originally placed. If you can draw a diagram, that would be better. But for me, I can remember this. These are just 6 screws. So I'm placing them here. Well, that was easy. So I actually can't judge if this looks refurbished. So I think it can be seen in the camera that the thermal pads have some markings from the VRAM. So I initially thought that the capacitors don't have thermal pads, but they do based on this. Oh no, this is for here. Okay, so this PCB is screwed to the backplate. I think it has 4 screws. But first, let's clean this up. So if you're not familiar on how to clean up a GPU, use a tissue with 99% alcohol. So they put a lot of thermal paste, which is okay. A lot of thermal paste is better than less thermal paste. Although Noctua will tell you otherwise. They will tell you that sometimes it degrades the performance. So as you can see, the GPU die is still silver. It looks new. Definitely looks new. The VRAM, however, not sure. For the VRAM. Oh, I finally seen it. It says Samsung. Anyway, this really looks new. There's no doubt that this is a new GPU. Doesn't look to be used. Doesn't look burnt. Even if it is used, it still looks new. Thermal pads looks like the thinnest one that you can buy, which is basically 0.5mm. I think I will not replace the thermal pads. For this, let's check the back. And as you can see, I was right, there are no thermal pads at the back. So this is just for rigidity and aesthetics purposes only. Anyway, I'll put this back together first so that I have less screws to remember. Set this aside for now. So as for the heatsink and shroud, this should also be straightforward. Okay. The fans can be removed. Can it be removed? Now this looks scary. It's not really a screw. It's probably something that you can pinch to remove the fan. It's not a screw, so be careful about this when you're going to replace the fan. But yeah, I think that's it for the teardown. As for this teardown's purposes, you can see the GPU is still clean. Doesn't look like it was refurbished. It really looks like new. The VRAM is a bit on the sketchier side. I don't think anything here is refurbished, but of course, I could be wrong. It could be cleaned so well. So yeah, I think I'll assemble this back later. As for the second part of this video, this is basically my RTX 3060 Aorus Elite update. Basically, I screwed up the mounting. After the last update, off-cam I removed the thermal pads from the VRAM and basically had the same performance. So what I did next is to follow what Noctua suggests in fastening their heatsink, which is to perform 3 turns on each screw until it is fully tightened. Without thermal pads on the VRAM, I ran FF15 benchmark again for 30 minutes and it averaged at 59.2 degrees Celsius with a hotspot average of 70.38 degrees Celsius. The next day, to make sure that my theory was correct, I opened up the GPU again and added the thermal pads with 0.5 mm thickness. I performed the Noctua suggested mounting again, and upon benchmarking FF15, the GPU averaged at 58.56 degrees Celsius with a hotspot average of 69.44 degrees Celsius and a max temp of 71.9 degrees Celsius. The benchmark also concluded with the same result as when it was new, which is around 91 FPS. In short, if you have a problem with your GPU suddenly slowing down due to overheating, I suggest to tear it down, clean it up, and most importantly, don't F up the mounting. Okay, so that's it for this video. Do leave a comment below on what you think about teardowns and GPU cleanups. Thanks for watching. Do like or dislike and subscribe for more unboxing and benchmark. Bye!